Good afternoon. Welcome to our channel, Isect College. I am Pratibha Kareel from Nursing Department of Madhuban College of Nursing, Indore, which is branch of COMP-FEEDE Group of Institution, Indore. Today my topic is disinfection from subject Microbiology. So let's start with the definition. It is the process of destruction or removal of microorganisms and reducing them to the level not harmful to health. The second one is disinfection is a process of killing microorganisms. In this disinfection process, a chemical substance is used. The chemical is called as disinfectant. That means it is a process of killing microorganism. In disinfection process, a chemical substance is used. This chemical substance is called disinfectant. This chemical is applied on living or non-living things to kill all microorganisms. In this process, all microorganisms get killed except some resistant fungal spores, and this disinfection process is less effective than sterilization. There are some points given below. Let's deal with them. The first one is disinfection generally kills the sensitive vegetative cells but not heat resistant endospores. The second one is, if the object is inanimate, means live place such as working area, dishes, benches, etc., the chemical agents is known as disinfectants. Next one is, however, if the object is animate, means living, such as human body tissue, the chemical is known as antiseptic. Next one is, disinfectant are usually bactericidal, but occasionally they may be bacteriostatics. Now, uses of disinfectant. Disinfectant are used on large scale and they are applied in various fields. So let's see them one by one. Firstly, disinfectant can be used in kitchen. It can be used in bathroom as a bathroom cleaner. It can be used on floor as a floor cleaner. It can be used as a hand wash. It can be also used in industries like food industry, brewery industry. It is also used in hospital and laboratory also. Then, next is properties. There are some properties. The first one is, it should be non-corrosive, inexpensive and effective. Second one is, it should be broad spectrum and should not cause deterioration of the object to which it is applied. Next one is, it should not be harmful to human being and animal. Next one is, it should have a pleasant odor. Next is, it must be soluble in water and safe for regular use. First of all, we dilute to it in water, so it should be soluble in water, and secondly, it should be safe for as regular use. Next one, it should not cause any kind of pollution when dispose of environment, so it should be safe. Definitely, it should not cause any kind of pollution when dispose of environment, because it should be safe. Okay, thank you. And The remaining content of this topic I will explain in my next video. Thank you. I hope आप सभी को समझ में आया होगा. Thank you.